Welcome back, baseball fans. Today, we are in the National League East, a series between the Marlins and Mets. Two teams trying to find the bottom of the National League East. Who gets there first? Let's see now what the needs are in this series here. And as we do that, we find that the Mets won a best of seven. They're plus one in the head-to-head. The Marlins are a half game back. So this is a traditional best of seven. If the Marlins win 4-3, they would be tied head-to-head, but the Marlins would get that half game in the standings, so there would be no tiebreaker. So that's why it's a best of seven. The Mets, again, they need to do something here. And we are going to show what has transpired thus far in the series. The Mets came into the All-Star break last in the league in hitting. But we think we've got their lineup figured out. Game one in Florida, the Mets come roaring out with four in the first, two in the second, one in the third. Florida has a late rally late, but it falls short. They win 9-7. They have Tommy G bats second against lefties, and Clendenon bats fourth against lefties. They figure that that's the strategy. And in game two against righties, Tommy A.G. leads off. Clendenon's on the bench. Strawberry and Brooks move up. Cranepole bat six. With Garrett and Cleon Jones batting second and third. This seems to be the lineup, finally. And the Mets are starting to tear it up. They started this game with a run in the first, four in the second, and four more in the third. And they win this game 10-7. The only reason this game was close was because in the second inning, Ashby reached on an error to Wayne Garrett. And then Jeff Leonard reached on an error to Wayne Garrett. And in the third, Vic D'Avelio reached on an error to Wayne Garrett. And so that game was a little bit more closer than they would have liked, 10-7. Then in game three, back in Shea Stadium, what would happen in... That's game one again. What would happen in game three with the series back in Shea Stadium? Well, the bats went dim, but the Mets had their guy, Jerry Kuzman. Jerry, they leave me in too long, Kuzman, but I don't care. He got that complete game. I think he's got like 100 complete games this year. They went 2-1. And the two runs that the Mets got were on a Don Clendenon homer in the four hole. So the Mets have, even though when they don't score a lot, they pitch well. They seem to have their pitching and hitting timed up rather well. And they desperately need to finish off these Marlins in game four if possible. And they become a legitimate playoff threat, finally. So that's what's up today. It's in Shea. It's time to put the dagger in the Marlins, you know, reel the fish in, and Sandy Vance for the Marlins against Sid Fernandez for the Mets. Let's get started. Leading off, here's our guy, penitentiary face, one flap down, Jeffrey Leonard, all the nicknames he has on baseballreference.com. Jeffrey Leonard, 5'10", is a walk. Grody's catching. He's got a minus three arm. So he will not steal. Manuel Mota, 2'5", is a 6'4", three double play. And Mickey Hatcher pops the first. All right, here's A.G. back in the leadoff spot against a righty. 2'6", it's okay. Wayne Garrett, 2'10", right or left. Cleon Jones, the heart and soul of the Mets, walks. And with two outs, it's Strawman, Daryl Strawberry. That's going to be a base hit because you had to hold Cleon Jones on. So runners are on the corners with two outs for Hubie Brooks. And he rolls to the mound. Tough one there. Chico Simone, 2-8. Okay. Pedro Guerrero, K's. And Krenolds struck him out. Bottom of two. Ed Cranepool rolls a second. Crody to the Max K's. And Bud Harrelson K's. Scoreless in the third. Rafael Santana, former Met, pops to first. Vic Davalio pops out. And Ken Southbound Suarez bounces a short. This is Harrelson. He makes the play. Okay. We have Willie Randolph in the bottom. He's really played much better since we put him in the nine hole in the lineup. 35, another Randolph hit. He's gotten on in every game. He's got two multiple hit games in the series. That's been the tonic. Bat him ninth. He can hit and run if Harrelson gets on. Tommy Agee, 67, a base hit in a right field. The speedy Randolph against the weak noodle arm of Davalio. Randolph will try and go coast to coast. He does. Runners are on the corners for Wayne Garrett. 56 is a K. They'll bring the infield up with runners on the corners and one out for Cleon Jones. 1-3. Lefty question mark. We're going to run Randolph against the Moda arm, and that is an RBI. 1-0. And with two outs, it's Strawman. 58. Flies right. Mets 1-0. Leonard. 5-11. K's. Mota. 35. This is the first hit of the game for the Marlins. A base hit. Mickey Hatcher rolls it to second. This is Randolph. He's a three. E15. Double play ball. Mets are playing. Winning baseball here in game four. Hubie Brooks, 66. Double one. Base hit. Ed Cranepool, 66. Base hit to center. Hubie's got some wheels, but it'll hold at second. Jerry Grody, 54. Pops a second. Bud Harrelson. Two sevens a walk. They are loaded with one out. They got to bring it up here. They're going to bring it up here for Randolph. The base is loaded to one out in the fourth inning. Chance for the Mets to blow this game open. Randolph, 2-11. They get a force out at the plate by bringing the infield up. Smart play by the Marlins there. So here it is. Tommy Agee leading off here. Base is loaded. Two outs. Chance to do something magical. And he cannot. He pops out to first. It's a 1-0 game for El Cid and the Mets. Chico Simone flies left. Pedro Guerrero, 37th K. Craig Reynolds, 57th K. A one-hitter for El Cid, facing the minimum number of batters. Wayne Garrett walks. Cleon Jones, 4-4, is third X. Third base is Reynolds. See a 331? Craig Reynolds? Third base is a 331. That's going to be a single. We have two men on for the straw. The straw that stirs the Mets drink. With two on, nobody out. This guy's all right. Hubie, Babel and Brooks, 47, is a pop to first. Ed Cranepool, two on, two outs. Cranepool, he flies to right. Sandy Vance has put 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 men on in five innings. The Mets have scored just once. Santana struck him out. Vic Davalio, 2-7, strikeout easily. Sid Fernandez, best outing of the year, without question. Roller to second, Randolph, he makes the play. 18 batters through six innings for El Cid with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 strikeouts. Outstanding. All right, Sandy Vance, this is his breaking inning. Both starters are overachieving today, and they're both starters sixes. Grody, single 1-12, is a base hit on 12. Bud Harrelson, 38, is single to right field. Okay, Randolph, two on, no one out, sixth inning. Don't like the bunt here, way too early to do that sort of thing. Randolph, 65, and finally they crash in on the Vance card. Triple 1-4, single dot dot. That's a single dot dot, and the Marlins are in trouble because they have a broken pitcher. They have nobody out. They're down two. There's two men on, and they are nine outs away from being eliminated. So, after five innings, the broken Vance, it's either if you pull him now, or you just throw in the You throw in the white towel and... You got Pina, Bergmeyer, and Camacho, and they're going to go... Yeah, they're going to hook him. They're going to hook him because they believe that their bullpen is actually better than Vance. And the overworked Marlin bullpen, who... They are the only three-man bullpen in the National League, as none of the Marlins starters go on the rotation. And Dave Leonard already pitched in this series, so it's Pina, Bergmeyer, and Camacho, and that's it. So here comes the first of those guys, Jose Pena. Here's his card. In the sixth inning, with runners on the corners with one out, they bring it up for Tommy AG. Here we go. The pitch. 39 AG is a base in the right field. Randolph. 15 to run against Davalio, 16 to run a third again. He does, and he's successful, and the run scores to boot. So you have runners on the corners with Wayne Garrett up and hold. Nobody out. 65, second C, but they have the infield up. Second and third for Cleon Jones. 58 is a K. They just can't put this thing away. Two on, two out. Strawberry. 110, he flies to right. Wow, they get two, but they left two men in scoring position with nobody out, and it's just a 3-0 game. Wow. That's just too much to take here. Mets, 3-0, making it difficult. Jeff Leonard, 53, left X. This is Cleon, he makes the catch. Manuel Motto has the only hit. He strikes out, and with two outs, Mickey Hatcher, he bounces to third. El Cid Fernandez, one of the best performances in Strat all year. Two base runners through seven innings. Seventh inning stretch. Background music by Lou Reed, the amazing Coney Island Baby LP. And in the bottom of the seventh, Pena will stick around. That was brilliant relief in the sixth. Hubie, Babylon Brooks in the seventh. 66 is a K. Ed Cranepool, 69. This guy's the center. And Grody, 44. Off of the Pena card. Homer 1 of 14, and it is gone. A solo shot off the Jose Pena card, and it's 4-0 Mets. And with two outs, it's Bud Harrelson. 62 Ks. Wow. I don't think I've shown any cards today. Anyway, we're in the eighth inning. 4-0. Six outs for El Cid. No defense to bring in. It's Chico Simone. 49, a walk. Okay. Pedro Guerrero. 1-7. Okay, base at left field. Okay, we got some warming in the bullpen now. But Reynolds is left-handed. So you have two on and no one out for Craig Reynolds. Here's the pitch. 2-10 is a 6-4-3 double play. Wow, that's huge for Cid. He gets to stick around for another batter. You got a runner at third, two outs for Rafael Santanaman. 5-11. Struck him out on a breaking roll on 5-11. But of course he's not broken. He almost is, but he isn't. And the shutout continues as well. Wow, 4-0. All right, Pena leaves after his two. And with the season looking like it's about to end in one more inning, the Marlins will bring in their lone all-star, Ernie Camacho. Congratulations, Ernie. He'll come on in the eighth inning. His career will be over too, as the 84 cards will be pulled out after the... this season's over, and it looks like this season's about to be over. Ernie Camacho against Willie Randolph, leading off the eighth inning. 39, another Randolph single. Let's show you the card if I haven't already. But he's got another multi-hit game. He was hitting 200 at the All-Star break. Let's see what he's doing now. We'll find that out in the post-game wrap. So he's on for Tommy AG. 66, lines the third. Wayne Garrett, 1-4, center. And Cleon, 2-7, short A+, but Randolph is not being held on base, no. All right, El Cid in the ninth. It's 4-0. Two base runners knocks him out. He's looking for a CGSO. Davalio, 5-10. Catcher's card, it's Grody. He's out. And K Ken, southbound Suarez, pops to first on another breaking die, I will mention. So, the Marlins just stumbled into this series. They're down to their final out. It's our man. Let's take a look at his card. Jeff Leonard, penitentiary phase, one flap down, two outs in the ninth inning. 53, left field X. It's a high can of corn to Cleon Jones, who's a 2-e-3. And he makes the grab. Made it interesting. But he makes the catch. And El Cid, and look out. We have a new team in the National League playoff race. They've come out of nowhere. But the Mets are alive and kicking here. Wow. How quickly things can turn. They were pretty much toast. They were dead. They had to sweep the Marlins in four straight, and that's exactly what they did. And the Mets are back, folks. Ernie Camacho gave up a hit. Jose Pena, he did all right in relief. Gave up a hit. Two hits, a run, and three Ks. Vance pitched his heart out. He just eventually put too many men on base and was charged with three of those runs that are all earned. And there's your box. 1-0-9-0-1-0-8-4-12-0-2. Wow. Holy heck. The National League's been turned upside down in this round of seven. So with a fourth straight win, yeah, the Marlins were 3 under, they finished 7 under .500. And the Mets have been granted a new life. So let's see what the standings look like here. 18-16. So the Mets are 18-16, that's, you know, they have life. I'm going to find out what Randolph's hitting. He's 32 for 135 now. So he brought his average up from 200 to 237 in just four games. Yeah, he was electric, helping the Mets at the bottom of the lineup. So 18 and 16. Let's see. Take a look at the 2020 postseason again. The Mets in a best of seven. The Mets won that 4-0. The Mets are 18-16 in Florida. I believe they're 14-21, right? Yeah. So Florida ends at 14-21. Well, again, they've been overachieving. They're an expansion team. They were 10-20 last year, so they're 14-21. Whoops. But let's look here at the current standings in the National League. So the Giants are still they got the number one away from Colorado by percentage points. We still have the Reds at three, and of course the Braves seem to be comfortable up front at four. And the last place teams are awful and are gone. Padres 9-21. You lose 21 games, you're gone. Las Vegas 8-21. Cardinals 9-21. Marlins 14-21. The interesting races we're seeing these flip-flops where the Cubs pass the Pirates and are 3 over .500. The Mets pass the Phillies and are 2 over .500. And then way down here, the Astros stumbled against the Padres and are 4 over .500. Dodgers are 6. So it's the Astros spot that could be in question in the next round, as the Cubs and the Mets are alive and well in the National League. So there you go. Hope you enjoyed that. Mets took care of business, made the National League more interesting, and we'll check you again next time. Have a great day.